So that was the 13th of the 32 studies by Rose for clarinet. And today we're going to talk about playing simply. Now, slow music is a perfect way to do this because we often complicate our playing by creating too much nuance in between certain notes, especially slow notes. So today we're going to simplify. We're going to Marie Kondo our clarinet playing, and we're going to spark joy in the simplicity of simple musical line. Let's get started. Now, Miles Davis, the famous jazz trumpet player, said something brilliant when he said that music is what happens between the notes, in the spaces between the notes. And what does that mean? Well, what that means is the notes themselves are just points in a musical phrase, but the line is what you draw between those points. So you can draw a simple line, or you can draw a super complicated line. This is what we're going to simplify. So the first step in fixing this is playing something that is slow simply and creating one simple line that connects those notes together into a musical phrase. A lot of young players, and even some not so young players, have a tendency or a habit of putting a crescendo decrescendo on every single note of a phrase. And this is what I call playing footballs. Now, if you imagine a football, it's tapered on both ends and it grows in the center to the ball shape. Now, you don't want to play that way. Now, let me demonstrate what it means to play footballs by playing a part of this etude. Now, some people may think, oh, well, that's super expressive and emotive, but my problem is that each note has its own space in the line and it disconnects itself from the other notes. What we want to do is we want to connect those notes, like Miles Davis says, and draw a simpler, cleaner line between them. And this is done by thinking larger dynamic movements and not individual note dynamics. Here's what I mean. So I'm drawing one line, and you can sort of trace the outline of my musical phrase, but you don't get bogged down in each individual note. This is done by creating a good support in your diaphragm. So this is your sternum, that's the center of your chest, your bone right there. If you go down below it a few, maybe let's say 5-6 centimeters or 2 or 3 inches, you're at the top of your diaphragm. This area here is what you need to activate. Now, activating a diaphragm doesn't mean tension. If you think about it, if you were lifting something heavy and you had to lift it up, you wouldn't be necessarily tense as you did it. You would just be supporting it with the muscles in your arm. The same thing is happening when you're supporting your airstream with that muscle of your diaphragm. Imagine yourself doing a half sit-up. You feel that right here in your core. That's active, and it supports your airstream going through the clarinet to have a nice single linear flow. You can take a breath while you're playing these things. You do not have to play it all in one breath in order to make it sound nice and flowy. But what you do have to remember is that when you take the breath, remember the volume and the sound and the trajectory of your phrase before you take the breath, and then after you start playing again, continue along the same line that you started. You don't want to start over again when you take a breath. You want to continue what you were doing before the breath. This is especially important, of course, if you're in the middle of a phrase when you need to take a breath. Let me demonstrate and show you what I mean. So I took a breath not in between measures, but at the end of what to me felt like a logical subphrase of the phrase. And that's the secret. If you take a breath in just an arbitrary place where you're running out of breath, for example, that may not be the best part of the music for you to be able to continue the line that you're playing. So planning your breaths, writing them in, practicing them as you're practicing the piece, always in the same place, you'll be able to get used to taking that breath and continuing a musical line. Okay, let's move on to the second topic, which is how to play fast stuff simply. Now, another common habit that I see younger players have is that within a slow piece of music, all of a sudden when there are fast notes, the attitude changes toward the piece. No, the piece is still a slow melodic piece, they're just faster notes. It doesn't mean it has to become more intense. Intensity often shows up as volume. This initial phrase of this etude is written as piano. Now that's soft, and it needs to remain a soft phrase. That doesn't mean that it's all soft, because there are crescendos and there's decrescendos, but that still means that it has a piano sensibility, which means not especially intense. It's espressivo, but calm. Second line of this is where the problem starts to happen, and that's where I'll pick it up. So you need a lot of support from your diaphragm. You need to lock your embouchure and not bite, specifically not bite as you're going over the break. But most importantly, just chill out. This is faster notes, but it's not changing the fact that it is a slow-moving phrase that goes to the end of that last C sharp before you take a breath. One last bonus that I'm going to tell you about is a fingering for that last D. Now this is very useful for a lot of other pieces, of course, and it is what we call the backless D. Now what this is a different fingering, but it allows you to go over the break of the altissimo for the final arpeggio as smooth as silk. Here's what it sounds like if I were to play the normal D fingering. Do you hear how it kind of pops out a little bit? Well, check out this fingering, and I'll put it right up here so you can see it as I play it. Amazing, isn't it? Super cool. You get that one for free. So playing music simply is not easy. It requires a lot of discipline. It requires that you focus and pay a lot of attention to your support and your airstream. It's a really good idea for you to sing them and then play them, because you will not naturally sing with a lot of different types of crescendi between all of the notes, because that sounds stupid. So don't play a way that you wouldn't sing, okay? Hope this was helpful. Once again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.